muscle fiber is containing organic phosphate. Write the word organic phosphate. Organic phosphates present in muscle break down to form inorganic phosphate and some organic compounds. This reaction releases energy which is used for contraction. So when your muscle contracts, the organic phosphate is broken down into inorganic phosphate and some organic compounds. So energy is released. To understand the energy process, this you must have a visualization. That oil now releases energy. So what happened to the oil? To release the energy which is hidden in the oil, it must join with the oxygen. It's called oxidation. At that time it comes in the form of heat and light. Same thing, when your muscle contracts, the energy is converted into, what is that? That energy must be converted so the muscle can. How the process is that organic phosphate is changed into inorganic phosphate and some organic compound, so the energy is released. First chemical reaction. Make sure you understand that. This reaction releases energy which is used for contraction. That's the energy which is used for contraction of the muscle fibers. In this first state, when the organic phosphate is changed to inorganic phosphate and organic compounds, energy is released to contract. There is no oxidation is involved in that first step. No oxidation, that means no oxygen is involved in the first step of contraction. It is done merely by changing the organic phosphate which in the muscle fibers breaks down into inorganic and so. No oxidation is involved since muscles can continue to contract normally for a short time when in an atmosphere containing no oxygen. So they did experiment. Muscles can contract in an atmosphere without oxygen. Yes. The cause is because it is not done with oxidation. The first contraction is done by change of this organic phosphate. So you understand that. Under these conditions, muscle fatigue more quickly than ordinarily, suggesting that oxidation are responsible for the recovery of muscle. Suppose if there is no oxygen in the contracted state due to breakdown of organic phosphate into inorganic phosphate, in that state it cannot continue to contract for a long time, muscle fatigue sets in. So the purpose of oxygen is to release this fatigue. If there is no oxygen, muscle cannot continue to function because fatigue sets in. So under this condition, muscle fatigue more quickly than ordinarily, suggesting that the oxidation are responsible for recovery of muscle. Write it. Oxidation are responsible for recovery of muscle. When muscle contracts, glycogen breaks down to lactic acid and additional energy is released. Now, there is, what is glycogen? It is sugar, carbohydrate metabolized in the body. In the blood, it is called glucose. Glucose, how, where did you get this glucose? It comes from the, so you take a piece of bread. Bread is carbohydrate. It contains three atoms. What are three basic atoms? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. But the bread itself directly cannot dissolve into the water. It's not water soluble. You take a piece of bread and put in the water, and put another glass, you put a little sugar dissolve, but the bread doesn't, it becomes soggy, but it doesn't dissolve. So how body is then able to dissolve that carbohydrate? Sugar also made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Why? How? And that's called digestion. So you put that carbohydrate, this bread, in your mouth and chew. After a few minutes, what happens? That bread becomes very sweet. It combines with the saliva and then the digestion. So carbohydrate digestion started in the, and so the molecules are broken, so it will become water soluble. So body can absorb that sugar for the active muscle. Of course, it takes place also inside the stomach also. But anyhow, the first understanding of how the carbohydrate become water soluble sugar. Same protein also, when it is digested, you call it what?
Amino acid,
that's right. The protein contains four atoms, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. Carbohydrate contains three atoms, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. And so the protein also, you need same process of where the body can convert and make it useful by converting into simple molecule from the complicated protein molecule of the bread or the cheese or milk or meat. Of course, yogis, you don't take meat, but anyhow, other proteins. So when that has been digested by the body, it becomes amino acid, so it can go into the bloodstream and the muscles can get, other cells can get it for repairing. So the you have taken a piece of bread or a couple of pieces of bread, it has gone into the system now, it's been converted into, and it must pass through the first thing, all the food must pass through the digested food, must pass through the, through which organ? Louder. Liver. It must pass through the liver. And the liver, from the liver, these, when the sugar or the carbohydrate is converted in the form of sugar or which is in the liver, that is called glycogen. Now, there is enough sugar in the liver and active muscles need all the time energy, and that energy must come from the sugar. And where is now sugar? It has been sent into the blood vessels. So blood vessels containing at a given moment sugar, and this sugar is called glucose, easily absorbed by the and used by the, so the fuel directly used by the active muscles, that's called glucose. But glucose also made up of three atoms. What are three atoms? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. There's no difference. So the glycogen, the sugar in the liver is called glycogen, and The sugar in the blood is called glucose. Now, as my muscles start moving, I am burning what? I am burning glucose. But active muscles need, because first contraction is done by organic phosphate. When it changes, you get contraction. But then muscles need further, so it has to burn fuel. That comes from burning of the glucose by combining with oxygen. So you get energy. So when the glucose made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen mixed with the oxygen atom, in order to release energy, it changes into carbon dioxide and water. Carbon plus oxygen become. Never leave this so close to me. Sometimes I must go. See, this is the carbohydrate, carbon . This makes a carbohydrate. Just like the oil, now to release the energy, oil must combine with the oxygen. So when this is, where this oxygen is coming now for the, it is coming through the blood by breathing. So you combine with oxygen, so any active muscles must burn. So what is happening? Carbon plus oxygen become carbon dioxide. Hydrogen plus oxygen become water. So it's not the matter is destroyed. It changed into different molecules, and thereby you get energy for the active muscles. Just like the car, you burn the gasoline with the oxygen, so you get energy to drive your car. Same process. So, when muscle contracts, the glycogen breaks down to lactic acid, additional energy is released. This energy is used for the reforming of organic phosphate from inorganic phosphate and organic compounds. You got that? This energy is used for the reforming of organic phosphate from inorganic phosphate and organic compounds. Muscle contracts because of organic phosphate change.